You've probably seen pro studios make use of mic preamps, and you may have wondered, why would I need one, and how would I use it?
Hi folks, I'm Mike, and I hope you will. Have you ever wondered why you may need a mic preamp, or even how to use a mic preamp, or which mic preamp is best for your interface? We'll be looking at all of those questions in today's video. Now, I happen to have the Audient ASP800, so we'll be taking a little bit of a closer look at that as well. And I'll be using that in a use case scenario where I'm going to make a little demo for you to listen to. But before we get into all of that, let's just ask, why would you want a mic preamp? A preamp takes a weak signal and it amplifies it to a usable level. Now, it's almost certain that your audio interface has preamps inside, as well as a whole bunch of other components and circuitry to deliver all of the features that you expect. Now, it may be in some cases that the quality of the preamps has been sacrificed in order to achieve all of these wider goals. On the other hand, with something like the ASP800, it is dedicated to this task. Physically, it has all the space it needs for this, and also the budget which goes into the device is focused on that task. I definitely think that one of the main reasons you may choose to get a mic preamp is for quality. Now, I've been using the ASP800 for around about 6 months or so, and it's absolutely crystal clear with everything that I plug into it, even when I'm driving it really, really hard. Now, it may be that you're really happy with the performance and features of your existing audio interface, and you simply want to extend the number of inputs available to you. And getting a mic preamp like the ASP800 is a great solution for this. Now, there's a couple of different ways you can do it. You can do it in the analog way, and the ASP800 has this DB25 connection on the back, and with a breakout cable, you could connect up with, say, XLR connections or quarter inch jacks. That's not my preferred way to do it because I think it's much better to use an ADAC connection. That is a digital connection. Now, I've already made a video, in actual fact, about how to do this exactly, where I connected the ASP800 to Audient ID 14 Mark II. So if you want to check that out, check the link in the description down below. It's a sort of a how-to, and you'll find out exactly how to do it. And it's really quite straightforward. Now, you don't have to match the brands together. So you could use the ASP800 with another brand of audio interface, for example, as long as it has that ADAT connection in. Okay, so that is a requirement for that. Now, it's not confusing once you've got it set up because it's not like your door, etc., sees two interfaces. It'll simply look like your existing audio interface just has a whole bunch of other inputs. Really quite straightforward to use, and it's crystal clear as well because you're getting that digital connection between the devices. Now, a lot of people, when they're using preamps like these to extend an interface, do it because they're going to be recording drums, and that's because drums require a lot of microphones to be recording simultaneously. But I think there's a lot of other use case scenarios, in actual fact. Even if you're recording, say, a duo with two acoustic guitars being recorded in stereo and two vocals, you're already up to 6 inputs there. And if you want them to be quality inputs, that could be a really good reason to get something like this. So things like bands, choirs, church groups, school groups, all of those are really valid reasons to extend a small interface with an interface like the ASP800, especially, as I say, if you want to get that quality. Now, a few months ago, I recorded a small acoustic group as a test run for the ASP800. But before you get to hear that, let's just have a quick chat about the setup involved. The whole session was recorded on a laptop with the ASP800 connected to an Audient ID 14 Mark II audio interface, giving a total of 10 available inputs. We were able to provide a variation of mixes to the performers by using the HEADAMP 6 headphone amplifier from ART. Given that we were not in a treated room, I opted to record the two vocals with a SHURE SM7B and a SHURE MV7, both dynamic microphones. The bass guitar was recorded with both a DI signal and a SHURE SM57 on the cabinet. By the way, the bass was recorded using a
special channel on the ASP800, which I will discuss later. Finally, the acoustic guitar was recorded using a matching pair of Neumann KM184 small diaphragm condenser microphones. You can find links to all of the gear used in the description down below. In total, 6 simultaneous inputs were used for this session, with what you could describe as a pretty mobile setup. So, let's have a listen to this short demo.
Left, we should learn. We should have shown before we burn. We should have crawled before we walked. We should have kissed before we talked. We should have looked before we turned. Should have held me from the start.
I never thought I'd need to.
Never let us drift apart.
I never thought I'd miss you.
We could have taught, we could have learned. We could have taken but returned. How did we ever dream so low?
By the way, a big thanks to Wayne Chandra for playing acoustic guitar on that track. Now, as I said earlier, you may choose to get a mic preamp for quality reasons, and you may like the crystal clear nature of something like the ASP800. But you may choose a mic preamp because it colours the sound, because the components and circuitry inside actually add some character to the sound. It may, in fact, only have one preamp on board, but you want to use it for that reason. And there's many preamps you can get for that reason. Now, as I said, the ASP800 has these really clear preamps, but it does have a couple of channels where they have circuitry on board to actually add that colour and character to your sound. This is the EMX and also the iron circuitry. They both have a little bit of a different character, with one adding some just sort of harmonic saturation and the other one having more of the style of a tape saturation, something like that. Now, I use them both for the bass guitar on this recording, and I have to say they're fairly subtle, and I think that's the way they should be, but they do add something, a little bit of character and warmth to things, especially when you drive them reasonably hard. So if you've been thinking of getting a mic preamp, I hope this has answered some of the basic questions for you. If not, ask in the comments down below and I'll try my very best to help you out. Now, if you're really interested on exactly how you connect up something like the ASP800 to an audio interface with ADAT, then you'll definitely be wanting to watch this video, which I mentioned earlier on. This is where I connect the ASP800 to an Audient ID 14 Mark II. It's really quite straightforward once you know how. Thank you so much for joining me today, and I'll see you in the next video.